Welcome to today's episode, and the daily motto is my name. We are to look at sexual cycles and the female reproductive system. Let's start by looking at the sexual cycles. By this we mean the different physiological changes that occur in the reproductive organs of an organism. Now, many animals have got sexual cycles in both males and females. These cycles occur in such a way that fertilization takes place at a time when the resultant offspring can best survive. Factors such as the climate, availability of food, control these processes. But then we shall take note that in humans, some of these factors may not control that much, because humans instead control these factors, and therefore when to bring about the offspring. We shall have to note that fertility is more controlled in females than in the males. Basically, placental mammals lie in one of these two cycles. It is either an oestrus cycle or a menstrual cycle. The oestrus cycle is divided into two. We have a monoestrous cycle, where the female undergoes a single period of sexual activity in a year. An example here is a deer. The counterpart is the polyoestrous cycle, where the female undergoes a series or a number of sexual activity within a year, but these are interrupted by periods of sexual inactivity. An example here is a horse. The second type of sexual cycle is the menstrual cycle. And here, the female undergoes a more or less continuous period of sexual activity, meaning the end of one cycle is immediately followed by the second sexual cycle. We shall discuss how the menstrual cycle is controlled in our next video.
The female reproductive system. It is made up of the following parts. Number one, ovaries. These are two and lie suspended in the abdominal cavity by ovarian ligaments. Their function is to produce ova and produce female hormones such as estrogen and progesterone. Number two, the womb or uterus. It is a hollow muscular organ, pear-shaped. It is about 5 centimeters wide and about 8 centimeters in length. It's held in position by ligaments joined to the pelvic girdle. It has walls of unstriated muscle and is lined internally by a mucous membrane called the endometrium. Its wall has 3 layers, that is the perimetrium, the myometrium, and the endometrium. Its function is to nourish and house the fertilized egg or developing fetus. Therefore, it is where implantation occurs. Number three, the cervix. It is a cylindrical neck of tissue. Its function is to connect the vagina to the uterus. Therefore, it regulates entry and exit into and out of the uterus. For example, movement of sperms into the uterus and movement of the developing fetus out during pregnancy. Number four, the fallopian tube or oviduct. It has a funnel-shaped open ending. The opening has finger-like projections called fimbriae. It is about 10 to 14 centimeters long. It has a muscular wall and is lined by a mucus secreting layer of ciliated epithelium. Its function is to provide space for fertilization. Number five, the vagina. It has a wall of unstriated muscle with an inner mucous membrane lined by stratified epithelium. It is therefore a muscular canal. It is an elastic canal with an inner soft flexible lining that provides lubrication and sensation. Its function is for birth and copulation, or one can call it is both a birth and a copulatory canal. Now, let us look at the external genitalia, and these are collectively known as the vulva. These are the outermost parts of the female reproductive system. Therefore, it takes us to the next part, or the next number, which is number 6, and that is labia majora, with a nickname of the large lip. It is simply an outer fold of a skin whose function is to enclose and protect the other external genitalia, and has sweat and sebaceous glands which produce lubricating secretions. Number 7, labia minora. It is an inner fold of a skin. It protects the opening of the urethra and the vagina. These skin folds, when elongated, are perceived to facilitate orgasm and female ejaculation. Number 8, the clitoris. It is anteriorly located to the vaginal opening. It's a small body of erectile tissue which is homologous to the penis in the males. It is vital in arousing sexual pleasure. Note that between the vaginal opening and the clitoris is the opening of the urethra and is not part of the reproductive system.
Brain stimulator. Number 1. Describe the structure and function of the different parts of the female reproductive system. Number 2. Describe how each of the following parts are adapted to their function. Part A, the fallopian tube. Part B, the uterus. Number 3, describe any two types of sexual cycles in animals. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.